Hey guys, good morning everyone. Welcome back to the online class. As you know that yesterday we have finished the chapter and we have taken a recap of the chapter also before starting the chapter. So today we are here to do the sum. We will summarize the chapter and later we'll discuss the chapter question answers of this chapter. Okay, the exercises what is given in this chapter. So a summarization is necessary because it will help you to understand the chapter well and it will help you to memorize it quickly, and you can summarize the chapter after listening this in your own words. That is the most important thing, because what I have seen that many of the students copied from other students, they copied from Google also, so that is not a good thing. I have told you to summarize the things only in your own words. You can summarize that only in your own word. After listening this summarization of this chapter done by me, you will be able to summarize the chapter by your own words. Okay, so I want that only, and later we'll discuss the exercise of this chapter. Okay, now we should begin this chapter, and I will suggest you that while watching this video, when I will discuss the exercises, you can take your book or pencil with you and you can mark the things when I will discuss it. Okay, so now let's begin the chapter. So earlier we have seen a starter here, an email was given, this was already discussed. We'll summarize the chapter now. Okay, so as we have seen that Hendrik was a boy who knew about this dikes and all the embankments was built to stop the sea water to come, to let it come in the whole land town. Okay, so it was built so that the sea water could not come into the their place and could not swipe up the the town. Okay, because that was situated under the level of the sea, right? It was situated below the level of the sea, so that was the problem. And so there were so many dikes, dikes were built from their ancestors' time, right? Hendrik's grandfather was the dike builder, his father looked after the dikes, and his uncle also looked after the dikes in the lower level areas. One day when Hendrik was roaming here and there, he could find a hole in that dike. He thought that this hole in the dike would lead a disaster to this, so he thought of doing something so that it will be helpful, and by the time if anyone will come, so he can inform him that the crack is there in the dike and it could be repaired soon. But as he stood there, he put his finger in that dike hole and stopped that water. But as the time passed, nobody came there, and he had to stand there for a long time. He stood there, he put his finger, and the weather was so chill that his whole body got numb with that chill air, and it was a cold time, and he holded that dyak hole with his little finger, and it just numbed whole arm and the right side of the body of Hendrik. Nobody came for the long time, and he had to stand there. It was quite painful for him also. But as the night grew, the dawn was when the dawn happened, a person came there, the laborer came there with his lantern, and he could find Hendrik, and Hendrik's parents were also searching for Hendrik. And when he saw Hendrik there, he just informed Hendrik's parent. They came there, and they seen how Hendrik Hendrik stopped this water and saved this dike, and he became the hero of that town because As you know that all the things got forgotten, but this could not be forgotten there, because that was the great deed what Henry did. He saved the whole land place. Otherwise, if he had not done this, it could lead to a disaster, right? It could lead to a disaster. So this happened, and he was quite. he was the place the town was saved. So it was written there, all the things we have forgotten, but the country is still grateful to the boy who kept his finger in the jack and saved all the things. Later, after seeing the Hendrick there, people's repaired the dike, and whole land was saved, right? So in this story we have seen that what is the moral of the story is that we should not get panic when the situation is hard. We should we should wait for the right time, and we should act wisely when the situation is not in our favor. Okay, we should not get panic by seeing the situation. Okay, we should get we should act wisely according to the situation. Okay, now we'll discuss the question answers. Okay, exercises of this chapter. The reading one first, say whether the following statements are true or false. Okay, you have to say this. I have given in your assignment too. You can take the help of this video and you can complete the assignments. If not for the dikes, Holland will be flooded. If there will be no dikes, Holland would be flooded. Yes or no? Yeah, it could be flooded. Hendrick was proud of the dikes built by his ancestors. Hendrick thought that the dike, he felt proud after seeing this dike which was built by their ancestors. Yeah, yes, true. Because Hendrick was a small boy, he could not understand that the trickle was dangerous. No, he understood that, right? If he had not understood this, he would have walked off from there, na? But he understood the disaster. He understood the dangerous could lead through this hole of the dike. So he stood there and he put his little finger in that dike. So no, the statement is wrong. You can write here false. Statement is wrong. Okay. Hendrick noticed a leak in the dike because he loved dikes and understood what the leak meant. A foreigner probably would not have noticed it. The answer will be Hendrick noticed a leak in the dike because he loved dikes and understood. Yeah, statement is correct. But the last statement is, I think it would be a foreigner probably would not have noticed it. Yeah. The statement is correct. You can write here true. When Hendrick located the leak, he ran to call for help. No, he stood there and he waited for anyone to arrive there or he could take the help. So he waited there. The statement is wrong. E statement is wrong. So you can write here false. Now choose the appropriate answer for the following questions. A. Hendrick expected help to come his way, but no help came till very late. The reason was that it was not a populated area. Late in the evening, a stormy cold night, yeah, a holiday. What it could be? A stormy cold night, okay? A stormy cold night. Hendrick found it hard to locate the leak of the following. Take the choices which are incorrect reasons for this. Hendrick found it means you have to find out the reasons which are given here wrong. For Hendrick found it hard to locate the leak. Okay. It was growing dark. It was a very small leak. He was a small child. The dike was too big for him to locate a small leak. Yeah, he was alone. Which of the statements are incorrect here? The statements are incorrect are he was alone and the dike was too big for him. No. He was a small child and he was alone. Okay. He was a small child and he was alone is a wrong statement. It is incorrect. Okay. Now let's see reading two. Most of the children, Hendrick's age, would not realize a leak, nor would they do anything to stop it. Which of the following words could be used to describe Hendrik's action and why? Now you have to use the word here. Some words are given here to describe Hendrik's action, and you have to say the reason also why you are choosing this. Okay, you can do it by yourself, but I am giving my thoughts or my points. Okay, so Hendrik's actions, for describing Hendrik's action, I would use heroic, selfless, and brave. Okay. Heroic means he acted like a hero because he stood there and he saved Holland town. Selfless means he did not thought of if he would have thought that standing there in cold will be harmful, he could have walked off from there, na? But he stood there selflessly, right? And he saved Holland town. And brave, yeah, he was quite brave. He did not afraid of that Dayak. Dayak hole. He stood there and he put that finger and saved that hole. And in every sentence, you can explain it in your own words, and you can tell your reasons too. Okay. What do you think are the different feelings Hendrik might have had while he waited for someone to pass by? You can he was quite in painful. He thought that anyone would have passed, it could be a help for him, but there were no one. You can write it by your own. Okay, you can take the I have explained, you know, you can write it. The country is still grateful to Hendrik because he prevented a great accident from happening. What could happened if Hendrik had not detected the leak in time? Yeah, it could lead to a disaster. All the town get sweep out with the sea water, and they could have died. Okay. Now let's see vocabulary. Words to describe types of wind. Here some table is given. One table is given. You have to study this table. Okay, types of wind. What the sea look like when this wind is blowing. What it looks like on the land, how it behaves on the land. What is the speed of the wind and the force. Okay, you have to memorize this. You have to memorize this table. Okay, light breeze, what it looks in the sea and what it looks on the land. Okay, the difference you have to study, and you have to study types of wind, you have to study the kilometers, you have to study the force, and you have to study the situations, the look on sea and on the land. Okay, the Hollanders have saved their land from the sea. This is a huge challenge because sometimes the sea can turn very rough. Yeah, sometimes sea can turn very rough, as we have seen some news is earlier, like 1 or 2 weeks earlier, you have seen about Kolkata and Mumbai. You have seen the sea, how it behaves during that some strong winds came there now. So it behaves very rough. Sometimes the sea action is quite rough. The movement of sea waves depend on wind speed. Here are a few terms from the Beaufort scale, a guide to wind speed and its effects on the land and sea. Learn the difference between breeze, gale, storm, and hurricane. Okay, you can study this from this table. Okay, you can take the help of this table, and I will suggest you that please study this. Okay, it will be helpful for you. Okay, it won't be a harmful for you, it will be a helpful thing for you. Okay, so I will suggest you please memorize it. Now about the grammar part. Interrogative pronoun. Yeah, you know that what is this interrogative pronoun. Yeah, yeah, I have told you what types of pronoun, right? So what is this? Remember, pronoun is a word we use in place of one noun, one or more noun. Yeah, pronoun, first what is pronoun? Pronoun is a word which is used instead of a noun or one noun or more noun. Okay, interrogative pronouns, what is that? Interrogative pronouns are pronouns used to ask questions. Okay, and they are who, what, which, and whose. Okay, so they are the interrogative pronoun: who, what, which, and whose. Why we use interrogative pronouns? We use interrogative pronouns who to refer a person, okay, who is, yeah, it is like we are, when we are using who, we are talking about person, we are referring to a person. What, we refers to the thing or idea. Yeah, when we are using what, we use to refer things or idea, which is used to refer to persons, things or idea, which is used to refer persons, things or idea. We use to make it, we use it to make a selection, okay. Like for example, we'll say which dress you want to wear for the party, which color you want, which is your favorite color. Like we use to make a selection. Whose, to show possession, yeah. Whose book is this, whose whose is this, like this we are talking about the possession. We have seen possession, possessive adjectives, we have seen that. Remember, some of these word can also be used as adjective, but an adjective is followed by a noun or pronoun, while a pronoun is used instead of a noun, okay. So example, which book are you reading, which adjective means if it followed by a noun, it will be an adjective, but means we are using this interrogative pronoun instead of a noun. So remember that, okay. Which do you mean means equal to pronoun we are using instead of a noun, then it comes as interrogative pronoun, okay. So I have given you this right in the assignment, fill in the blanks with the right interrogative pronouns, okay. Dash want to cook Italian food today. Who wants to cook Italian food today? B, dash is the name of the dish you want to cook. What is the name of the dish you want to cook? Dash is your apron. Which is your apron? Dash is this pan. Where is your, where is this, no, is this pan, which, where is this pan? Maybe dash is good at cooking pasta. Who is good at cooking pasta? Dash is the recipe for spaghetti alla carbonara. Maybe some food name. So what is the recipe for spaghetti? Okay. And I have given you this question also in the assignment, that read the story. You first of all, you have to read the story, and after that you have to frame three questions based on the story, okay. You have to frame a three question by using who, what, which and whose, okay. You have to frame only three questions. You can use any of the these interrogative pronouns, who, what, which and whose, okay. Now it is using the dictionary. You know, in dictionary we use we must see some of these symbols before the words, right? So what does it means? When we are finding about mouse, mouse is a head word. MAUS, what is given in the slash, between of the slash, that is the pronunciation, that how we are pronunciating it, okay. And next it is given noun. So it is a word class, that mouse means what kind of word it is. It is a noun. And the whether they, it is C, it is written there what type of noun it is. Then it is whether it is countable or uncountable, okay. And also plural form is also given there. So you can take the help of dictionary and you can find these all the things in that, and you'll be able to identify the word classes for the head words given below and mention the word class next to the bird, okay. You have seen this type of things is given in the dictionary. You can open the dictionary and you can take the help for finding these word meanings, word meanings also, and you have to find the word class or classes, okay, for the given head word. Like this, it is written there in a mouse, mouse noun, it is given word class you have to find, and you have to find the types of class also. If it is noun, then which class it is, countable or uncountable. If it is adjective, what kind of adjective, okay. You can take the help of dictionary and you can find it. And now it is about the letter. Yeah, as you have seen in the in starter of the means in the starting of the chapter, one email was given, right? One email was given, na? So this is the reason why email was given. Okay, why email was given? You have to use that for writing letters. You must have written some of the letters. This is called, we are here to read the personal letter. Okay. So how we are writing a personal letter? Personal letter or informal letter are written to friends or close relatives. We are writing personal. We are not writing personal letter to teachers or office mates or any principals. Or we are writing this personal letter, and we used to say this informal letter also. We used to write this personal letter to your friends, or we are writing this to our close relatives also. Okay, it is usually written in a warm and friendly manner. Yeah. When we are writing this kind of letter, we are putting our all love or all the things means conveying points so that it could be feel like a very friendly manner. Even today in the age of emails and phone messages, people love receiving handwritten personal letters. Here is a letter Hendrik wrote to his grandfather. Okay. So whatever the things is required before starting the letter. Okay. So personal letter is written with the whole means you can write with your all heart, and you can include all the love for that person. Okay, so first you have to write the sender's address. First you have to write your first of all, you have to write your address, you have to write date, greeting the receiver, that dear or my love, my lovely, whatever the things. Yeah, first you have to write your address, then the date, then your the way how you express your, how you instill to that person. Okay. An interesting opening paragraph. Yeah, first of all, when we are writing a letter, you just ask means interesting things should be added there, like I'm so happy I'm coming to stay with you for a month, I just can't wait for next weekend, I love the winter break because I can be with you. And this is an example. You can write that in our family, maybe all the members are happy, and I'm coming to this and such and such women's so and so weeks for these many days, and I love to spend my times with you. So this can be the things you can include there. Okay, then comes the body of the letter, the main thing what you want to explain it. Okay, the body of the letter means the main thing you want to explain in it. I have to tell you about an interesting incident, such and such and blah blah blah. You can write there about you, and then an interesting closing paragraph you have to write. Okay, and a complimentary, see you soon, get well soon, or if you are writing about means to your personal, if the reason is there, you can write get well soon, see you soon, to my love. Okay, and at last you can write your name. Okay, the signature it is written, you can write your name. Okay, so this is the things what we have seen today. Okay, so this is this how we write the letter. Okay, personal letter, you got it na? Yeah. So dictionary work is you have to do. Just fill your book completely. Okay, this will be helpful for you, and complete all the books portion exercises, and go through the video properly. It would be helpful for you to write the question answers if I'm asking it from by my own. Okay, if I'm asking some inside questions. Okay, so go through the chapter well, so it will be helpful, and summarize the story in your own word. Okay, so have a nice day to all.